I'm Crystal Edwards, superintendent. I'd like to welcome everybody to our spring recognitions and our board meeting. And we have a lot of awards tonight, so I'm really proud about that. But before we get started, I have a special guest who's here with us. His name is Teddy. He is a seventh grader. Come on out, Teddy. And Teddy's gonna perform a solo, and I'll have a lot more to say about that a little later. But for right now, let's give Teddy our uninvited attention for his solo. Thank you, Teddy, for sharing with us. And I'm going to keep the program moving. We're going to bring Teddy back later. I'll tell you what that was about. We have some more exciting news. And to talk about this exciting news, I'm going to introduce Mr. Stephen Prentice, who is our Informational Technology Supervisor. Mr. Prentice.
Good evening. If you were at our community conversation last fall, you remember we talked about the district app, and now it is a reality. LTPS to go is now available. When you download it, you can select your home school. Very easy to change between schools or use the district site. If you select a home school, from there, you can look at district and school news items, check out what's for lunch. You can see calendar events. You can check out the district snippets channel to see some videos. And all of this is available right now on the iPhone App Store and through Google Play. Works on both cell phones and on tablets.
Looking forward to using that. I never know what's for lunch. Okay. All right. Moving along. Here we go. All right. The New Jersey Alliance for Social Emotional and Character Development has selected Lawrence High School as a 2014 New Jersey School of Character and our entire Lawrence District as a 2014 New Jersey District of Character. Yes, we can clap for that.
Both LHS and LTPS will maintain the status for 3 years, and our applications were forwarded to the Character Education Partnership in Washington for consideration for national schools and National District of Character. We were recently notified that our district was selected as a finalist for a National District of Character. So now all 7 schools are New Jersey Schools of Character, 2 schools are national schools, Eldridge Park and LES, and now our district is up for as a finalist for National District of Character. And that meeting is going to be a site visit. We're going to have people here, and that's going to be on April 23rd, correct? So it's excited about that. The application, they shouldn't even call it an application, it's more of a dissertation. It is a big, big product. Shows all of our achievements. It's very extensive, but there are a couple people who really made this happen, who pushed forward and led us. And one of them is Allison Fisher, who is the LHS assistant principal. Allison led the committee at the high school. I don't know if she's here. Okay, she's back there. And the other is, here she comes, is Ms. Fisher, and Cindy Westhead, who is the LIS assistant principal, who led the district committee. And then we have a lot of people who were involved in this. So if you were involved in the character ed for either the high school or the district, would you please come forward and join us? Anybody who was involved in that process? And the entire high school committee is here. There you go, there's our high school committee. Could someone tell me how much you got paid to do this? Yeah, that's exactly what I thought. All of the work for this Character Ed Award, yeah, on the risers, there's risers over there. The work that these talented individuals did to make this happen, this is all volunteer work. And you have a bunch of very dedicated individuals who work sometimes 3, 4, or 5 hours after work just to really make this happen. Let's do the high school first, then we'll do the district. All right, high school. Okay. And now for the district. And the whole entire team, we took over a section of the Avon Theater at Rider University in March when they had their Character Education Conference, and we went to receive our award there. So that was another beautiful ceremony. In addition to receiving our award, I think we had a lot of people on from our district who did presentations for Character Education as well. So again, congrats to the Character Ed Committee. Okay, next up, another one of my favorite things to do is receive money. So I'm gonna invite Ivy Cohen and Paul up from LTEF to talk about spring grants. Thank
you. Hi everybody, I'm Paul Schindel. I'm the president of the board of the Lawrence Township Education Foundation. This is Ivy Cohen, our executive director. And this is one of the favorite things we get to do, which is to give money to the district that will touch every school in the district, virtually every student in the district with these grants. And this is money that has come from you, from parents and people in the community, as well as our institutional and corporate funders. And so what you hear is thanks to you, and we appreciate your donations, your support of Lawrence Township Education Foundation. This time around, we have 20 grants that we are awarding in various amounts that range from $160 to $7,500 each. And they touch, or they are being, have been received from and will be administered to all of our students by 73 teachers, many of whom are here. And we're going to ask them to stay put for the time being, and then we'll ask everybody to come up for a photo at the end of this list. The first up is a grant to Lawrence High School for Shakespeare, Understanding Drama through Performance Art. There'll be an artist in residence from the Philadelphia Shakespeare Company here next year working with the English students.
The next program is Be the Change, Lawrence High School Challenge Day 2014, $6,400. This will be the second year that LTEF is proud to fund this program that impacts hundreds of Lawrence High School students for character development.
After that, at Eldridge Park School, we are funding the development and installation of what's being called the Falcon Frieze, which is a character ed kind of monument that will be added to year after year, involving the third grade students.
Next is a grant to Slackwood Elementary School called Sensory Tools for $732. There's sensory products to help enhance the autistic support program at their school.
At Ben Franklin School, there's software being used for first, second, and third grade math students that integrates with their classroom smart boards.
Also at Ben Franklin is a program called It's Not Fiction, that reading is important. So it's a collection of leveled reading collections for kindergarten through third grade of nonfiction texts.
And next up, a grant that will affect all of the elementary schools. It's called Nature Studies Across the District, and it will expand and enhance the outdoor learning experiences in each of the elementary schools with things like weather stations and other ways of learning, bringing learning outside and to the, you know, meteorology and the whole thing.
At Lawrenceville Elementary School, a grant called Pollination for the Next Generation. This is a science program for second grade students for them to create hand pollinators for their science unit.
And at Lawrenceville Elementary School, a program that involves engineering for third grade students dealing with materials, and specifically this one is called Solid as a Rock.
Fifth grade students at the intermediate school will be excited to get Minecraft EDU. The software and network server will be launched over at the intermediate school next year. I see somebody here is pretty excited about that.
The Minecraft EDU program is of the students and parents here, raise your hands if you're familiar with or use Minecraft. Oh yeah, a whole lot of you. So the education version of this takes out some of the less desirable elements of that and adds a lot of modules that are trackable by teachers so they can mark the progress of students as they develop their universes. Oh, and then I'm up again. Minecraft, very many. iPad motivation. This is a grant that will provide special ed teachers at the intermediate school with iPads and apps that give them a virtual toolbox of learning applications that are appropriate for their developmental level.
Also, we're funding part two of an iPad motivation grant that was funded last year for ASI and RTI students. We're giving them funding for additional apps to use on their iPads.
Let's see, at Lawrence Intermediate School, a program to help some special needs rising seventh graders, sixth graders, to orient them better to the middle school as they're on their way into the school.
This next grant at Lawrence Intermediate School is pretty neat. It's a 3D printer, so it's some technology to allow students to experience the complete engineering process.
And next up, this is at Lawrence Middle School, following up on a grant that we awarded last year to the high school for what's sometimes known as a Harkness table or a collaborative learning table. We are funding one of those for the middle school. It's been a very successful in high school, and we look forward to more success from that approach in the middle school.
Also at Lawrence Middle School, CrossFit Kids curriculum, so some equipment, exercises, and skills to build a comprehensive physical education program.
At the middle school, a program called Finding Your Way. This is a professional development program that will work with the middle school faculty, sort of training them in many of the awarenesses that come from the Let Me Learn program, which most of our kids have experienced at lower grade levels. So that'll be integrated up into the middle school.
The Smart Music for the 21st Century Learner is going to receive some new computer hardware and smart music subscriptions for their music students.
And one 3D printer is not enough. So there will be one that Ivy mentioned in the intermediate school, and another one that will be in the middle school. These are both printers that are very tied into the development of STEM education, science, technology, engineering, and math, which is so important to our national competitiveness.
And the last grant is called a Flow Style School Assembly Program. It's a character education assembly focused on the importance of physical and mental well-being.
So altogether, we're looking at $62,854. We'll ask, as many of the 74 teachers and administrators who were involved in applying for these grants as are here tonight, to please join us so we can get a little photo. Come on down.
Congratulations and thank you. Okay, now I'd like to invite a special group of people to the front, if you're here. So Mrs. Amett, Mr. Beal, Ms. Clark, Ms. Damon, Mr. Fillmore, Mrs. Kirshner, Mr. Padron, Ms. Mazuka, Ms. Rello, Mr. Rigby, Mr. Taglarino, and Ms. Beers, if you're here, come forward. Very special award. Okay. This is our music department across the district. So let me tell you about their award. The NAM Foundation recently announced that LTPS, I would do my clapping, LTPS is named one of 2014 best communities for music education based on the results of its survey, which acknowledges schools and districts across the United States for their commitment to and support for music education in our schools. The survey requires districts to answer detailed questions about funding, graduation requirements, music class participation, instruction time, facilities, support for the program, which we have a lot of, and community music making programs. LTPS is one of 376 districts to receive this award out of 2,000 districts and schools that apply. So congratulations to our music department. Congratulations, music department. And now back to Teddy. Where is Teddy? Come on up, Teddy. So we heard Teddy play and we know he's talented. But Teddy was also accepted into the Central Jersey Music Educators Association Chamber String Orchestra for the double bass. He received the highest score of all the basses that were accepted and was the principal bass player for the orchestra in the concert. The highest score. And there's more. Recently, Teddy learned he was also accepted into the New Jersey Music Educators Association Intermediate All-Star or All-State Orchestra for the double bass. In April, he will have a seating audition for the final placement before performing in a concert with the All-Star Orchestra, which will feature the top student musicians from all three regions. Teddy is a member of the LMS Orchestra under the direction of Miss Melissa Clark. Congratulations, Teddy. Continuing with our awards, is David Connolly here? Come on down, David. David's a sophomore, and he was the winner in the American Asian Fine Arts Association's 9th annual Young Artist Music Competition. He performed a piano piece by Edward Grieg at the Young Artist Music Competition Winner's Recital at Carnegie Hall, impressive, on February 22nd. So congratulations to David. Congratulations. As you can see, we have a very talented music community. Okay, onward. The next award is actually going to be pretty large. We're going to talk a little bit about St. Baldrick's, the St. Baldrick's Foundation. Yes, you can clap. It's a volunteer-driven charity committed to funding the most prominent research to find cures for childhood cancers and give survivors long and healthy lives. This year's St. Baldrick's fundraiser took place on March 15th at Amalfi's in Lawrenceville. Participants of all ages placed personal vanity aside by having their heads shaved in support of children undergoing cancer treatment. And our teams of students, and we had them across the district, teams of students, staff, and parents from all 7 schools participated as shavees or volunteers in this community event, which raised over $141,000 for cancer in one day. That is very, very impressive. So what I would like to do is call you up by school. We have a certificate per school. So if I could start with Ben Franklin, if any of my Ben Franklin students, staff members are here, come on down. And by the way, the Ben Franklin principal is not here today, because he is welcoming a new member to his family that was born late last night. Okay. Eldridge Park. Lawrenceville. Team Lawrenceville. Blackwood team. the very proud Slackwood team. And team LIS. Students' hair grows back, but my principal's not so much. And middle school. Yeah.
school. Here we come, lads. So as you can see, we have a lot of students and family members and staff members that dedicate their hair to this event, so congratulations. Okay, my next award goes to a very special Ben Franklin second grader. Is it Sandia here? Sandia earned an honorable mention in the high merit category for her entry celebrating art contest, falling within the top 5% of all the entries that were submitted. This isn't a little competition. This is a nationwide competition. It's held twice a year for students in grades K through 12, and she's in second grade. And only the top 25% of the entries are selected for publication. Her artwork will appear in the fall 2013 edition of Celebrating Art. Congratulations. Krista, come on down. Is Krista here? Krista's a senior at Lawrence High School, and she received an honorable mention award in the Northern New Jersey Regional Scholastic Art and Writing Awards Competition. A jury of 30 professional artists, curators, and art educators spent 30 hours reviewing approximately 3,500 works of art submitted by over 900 individual students across New Jersey and selected hers. So congratulations. Next, is it Saloni or Saloni? Saloni, come on down. And Saloni is a sixth grader at LIS, and she's also a featured writer in the spring 2014 edition of the Kotzen Children's Library at Princeton University Picture Book Press. Her poem, Drifting Leaf, was chosen for publication and appears on page 2 of the Picture Book Press. So we have a published artist here for poetry. Congratulations. Congratulations. And we have a couple students receiving the next award. So if you are here, please come on down while I talk about the Aspirations Award. These Lawrence High School students were selected to have their work published in Aspirations, the literary magazine of Mercer County Community College. Their pieces were submitted for consideration by their teachers, Mrs. Ingram, Mrs. Eng, and Mrs. Green. Krista, Shay, and Leanna, right? We have three that I think we're going to be here.
This is Krista.
And Budula, is that how you say your name?
Batula.
Batula. Congratulations, ladies. Okay. Next up, Miss Natasha Vargas. Oh, here she comes. So senior Natasha won first place at the New Jersey State Poetry Out Loud competition
at the New Jersey Performing Arts Center in Newark. As a state champion, she'll represent New Jersey and LHS in the final round of the national recitation competition or contest presented by the National Endowment for the Arts and the Poetry Foundation in Washington. Now in its ninth year, the New Jersey competition began in September, where 28,618 students in 148 high schools across the state memorized and recited works in their contests held in their classrooms, schools, and regions. Mrs. Henderson, who is also here, I think, Ms. Henderson, is the Poetry Out Loud coordinator. So congratulations to both of you. From the arts to engineering. Okay, we had a couple students who entered the Mercer Science and Engineering Fair. We had students from LIS, LMS, and LHS. They had a strong showing at the Mercer Science and Engineering Fair held at Rider University, winning awards in all divisions. In fact, LIS won an award for having the most award winners in the elementary division. And here are our winners. So if you are here, please come forward. I think it's Arnav's here. Riddy is here. Ayana. And Aiden. Anisha. Teddy's here. Ethan. And Abian. And Jessica. I have more too. On the next slide, thank you. Pranav is here too, correct? Did I skip anybody? I don't want to miss a name. Okay. And that's the junior division and the high school division. So. Because as a parent, I wanted to take a picture of the slide that my kid was on, so you didn't get that shot. Okay, moving on, TSA competition. Okay, several LMS students attended the Technology Student Association competition at TCNJ, where they competed against students from other New Jersey middle schools. TSA is a national nonprofit organization of middle and high school students who have a strong interest in technology. Competitions feature problems in communication, design and engineering, environmental systems, manufacturing and construction, and transportation. In both team and individual events, students are challenged to use and improve their STEM skills. The team of Russell, Andrew, and Alex, are they here? Russell, Andrew, and Alex? Come on down. Submitted their entry call, Engineering Your Future, in the website design category, and they won fifth place. Congratulations. Mr. Robinson is here too. Okay, our robotics teacher. Congratulations, guys. Okay, Dan Green, is Dan here? Dan's a senior here at Lawrence High School. He has been named a 2014 National Achievement Scholarship finalist. This was based on his PSAT score from his junior year, as well as his continued excellence in the classroom. He's a finalist. A couple other finalists here. Brian, come on down, Brian. So So Brian's also a senior and was named as a finalist in the 2014 National Merit Scholarship Program. And the actual scholarship winners will be notified sometime in between April and July. Congratulations. So this next name I think you'll know. Yeah, Nick. Is Nick here? All right. Nick is a senior here at Lawrence High School, also the varsity quarterback for our football team. He was named a scholar, leader, athlete by the Delaware Valley chapter of the National Football Foundation and College Hall of Fame. And Coach Raddus, who recently retired as a varsity head coach, received a contribution to amateur football award from the Delaware Valley chapter of the National Football Foundation and College Hall of Fame. So congratulations to both. All right, there's the Coach Raddus Award. Okay. All right, is Coach Williams here, girls basketball? Come on down. I've been doing this for 3 years, and Coach Williams is a much better speaker than I am. So I'm gonna, yes, I'm gonna let you speak about the girls.
Oh boy, okay, I'm just gonna turn it down. All right, first and foremost, thank you so much for recognizing us every year. Our girls and our boys sitting back there for basketball, Coach Westhead knows it's a tough season. You're in that gym sometimes till 9 o'clock at night, 9:30 at night, just practicing. Thank you for recognizing all the players tonight. But I have two girls from the varsity girls basketball team this year that I would love to recognize. They were two captains who were voted so unanimously by the entire team. I couldn't agree with the team more. So the first one up is Tatiana Hewitt. Come on up top. Now, Tatiana was a senior CYO All-Star, and she also got honorable mention by the Trentonian. Most importantly, I just thought she really brought the team together this year, and she was a positive role model for us on the court. Next player up, Dominique Peters. Dominique this season got a second team All-CBCBA. She got third team by the Trentonian. In the state of New Jersey, she actually received honorable mention from Mercer County. And she also broke the most blocks in a single season with 66, which is about 3 per game. She still cannot block my shot, though, because she goes for the fake every time. Dominique Peters.
Congratulations. Congratulations. Okay, Coach Molinelli, come on down.
How's everybody doing? All you guys come down. We have support from our whole team to win individual awards. Takes our whole team. So our guys that are here, can you all come down, please? This is a very special group. A lot of them have been playing basketball together since fourth grade. We have 10 seniors this year, which is an incredible tribute to them and how hard they've worked over their careers here. I was fortunate enough to get to work with them the last 2 years. And while I was here, we won a sectional title together. We've won 35 games over the last 2 years. Our record in states is 5-2, and that's just a credit to their hard work. And we've gotten a ton better as the year progressed, and that's a credit to them and their great kids. And the school's definitely going to miss them a lot. And we have some juniors over there that are coming back, which is great as well. So for the individual awards, we had Jordan Glover. Jordan. Jordan made first team All-CBC for our coaches poll. He made first team All-CBC for the Trentonian and the Trenton Times. He was also part of the CY All-Star game as well, Jordan Glover. Next up, Cameron Kitchen. I think he was surprised about this one. I haven't told him yet, but he got honorable mention in the Trentonian newspaper. Next up, Samai Mitchell. Samai is one of our better defenders, and he made honorable mention in the Trentonian as well. Next up, he had AAU practice, so he wasn't here. A freshman, Miles Mitchell, he made third team for the Trenton Times. He made honorable mention for the CBC Coaches Association, and he also made honorable mention for the Trentonian as well. And last up is Jaquiel Parkman. Jaquiel played JV as a junior, and he's one of our most improved players. He came back this year. He's our third leading scorer. He made second team All-CVC in the Trentonian. He's one of the leaders in three-point shooting in our league, and he's looking to play college basketball as well, so I'm definitely proud of him, Jaquiel Parkman, and this is our 2013-14 basketball team. Thank you.
Hey, congratulations. Congratulations. And I'm going to invite our athletic director to come up and help me out with the next couple awards. Tonight is actually parent-teacher conferences at the high school, so a lot of our coaches and teachers are getting ready for their parent-teacher conferences, so they're not here tonight. Our next award is the ice hockey team, and Coach Richie could not be here. But we do have some awards.
Yeah, I'm going to go with the ice hockey team. I know Coach John Ritchie's probably in classroom. He's not out here, correct?
Correct.
Okay, Julian Bolton, all CVC, second team. Julian here? Okay, we'll go to the next. Anybody from the ice hockey team? How about if we go there? Come on up, guys. Nobody? Nobody from ice hockey. Okay. Well, we did have an all-CVC goalie, Travis Pelkey. For those of you who don't understand the ice hockey, how we worked it this year, we co-opted with Ewing High School, and Travis was he was the Trentonian Player of the Year. He's from Ewing, but he's representing Lawrence, and you know, we were just happy to have him. And then also Brian Resnikoff was a second team selection, but nobody's here, so we'll go to the next team. How about Corey? Is Corey here? Okay. Nope. All right. How about swimming? I know we got some swimmers out there. I saw Kate. So we got, I know Mr. Underwood is in class. Kate was second team All-State among many other awards to list for her. She was also our 2014 Mercer County champion and meet record holder in both the 50 and 100 meter freestyle, most valuable swimmer of the meet for the third year in a row. She placed second in the 50 free, fourth in 100 free at the NJSA Meet of Champions. She was the 2014 Girls Swimmer of the Year by both papers, was a 2014 All-CVC, All-Area, All-CVC First All-Star Team, All-South Jersey First Team, and All-Team second team All-State, like I said, by the Star Ledger, Kate O'Rourke.
Wow, that's impressive.
And let's get the rest of the girls up here as soon as we get done with that. We'll do one picture with Kate, I guess, or one. All right, good job. How about boys? We got some boys, there we go. Okay, once again, Mr. Underwood is in class, but we have some boys coming on down here. They were the 2014 CVC Patriot Division champs. All right, guys. I'll just read their accomplishments. You got Joey Carpinella, all CVC honorable mention from the Trentonian. Matt Francescini, all CBC honorable mention from the Trentonian. Jack Hargraves Dix, 2014 all CBC honorable mention from the Trentonian. Patrick Lavery, all CBC second team from the Trentonian.
Congratulations, swimmers.
Okay, I'm going to bring down my head wrestling coach, Chris Lynn. He'll introduce his wrestlers. Chris has been here, 28 years, Chris? 28. Does a great job.
I'll wing it as usual. 28 years, just wing it. Okay. First, what I'd like to recognize is probably one of my favorite wrestlers and one of our team captains and seniors. Gavin Shank was, as a coaching community, as the Mercer County wrestling coaches, Gavin, come on up. We have an award every year. It's the Gary Dambro Award, and he was my high school coach, and he put 45 years into coaching in Mercer County, and so we have an annual award for the wrestler most dedicated to the sport, and of all the teams in the county, Gavin won the award this year.
Congratulations.
And he also finished with over 50 wins, too. So we're very proud of Gavin. Our second award was to Mike Jennings, who couldn't be here tonight because one of his grandparents passed away. But Mike was the all-time winningest wrestler in Mercer County history with 119 wins this year. Well, in his career, school history. He was also the one of few that was a four-time Mercer County tournament champion, three-time region place winner, three-time district finalist. He was just a phenomenal wrestler for us. It's a shame he couldn't be here. He was also first team all county, Mike Jennings. So, applause to Mike. Third person we'd like to recognize is Georgie Joachim. Georgie, come on down. Georgie is a two-time district place winner and was also a Mercer County finalist this year and one of our team captains and always got the coin flip for us. And last but not least, Gordon Wolf, one of our seniors. He's the only wrestler in Lawrence history to qualify for the state tournament three times. He had placed fifth in the state last year. He finished one win behind Mike. He has 118 wins. He is a three-time Mercer County tournament champion, four-time district finalist, three-time region place winner, and obviously qualified for the state tournament three times. And first team all-county, Gordon Wolf. Georgie reminded he was second team all CBC.
Okay, so, yes, let's clap for all of our athletes, musicians, scholars. We certainly have a group of children who do know how to lead, achieve, and succeed. So that concludes our program. There are refreshments outside, and thank you. We'll be starting a board meeting in here in about 5 to 10 minutes. So thank you.